So yes, we have now come back with the review series of reviewing all the Bojack Horseman seasons. I know it's been a while, but I've been doing other stuff and have been interested in making other stuff. And so I guess without further ado, let's get into it and talk about season two of Bojack Horseman. Now, season one was really sort of started everything, introduced us to everything, the arcs, the stories, lines, etc. But season two really gave us the quality that we expect from the series from here on out. I love the whole idea and concept that we get to see in the beginning of the season, in the very first episode, with the flashback of Bojack and his household life as a kid, as we see him listening into the TV over his parents arguing, listening so intently to what Secretary was saying to him that it became his entire life's motto. Then us seeing Bojack trying to turn his life around and become a more positive and happy person, and it goes to the point where it messes up his job so much that he needs to call his mother to push him back into that sad place in reality. The phone call with Bojack and his mother is probably one of the most sad and depressing moments in the series, because she tries to, in a way, push him back into that sort of depressed and saddened state that we saw of him in the first season. This whole idea of hopelessness, that he feels there's no way that he can save himself, no way he can change or improve himself or move on from everything, and that nothing can really change who he really is and how miserable he is as a person. It's one of the saddest moments in the show, and it really shows how harshly true it can be sometimes and how wrong in other ways it can be sometimes with what it shows us. Then we get introduced to Wanda, who is such a fascinating character to me and the perfect contrast to Bojack. I feel like it genuinely makes perfect sense why Bojack has such an interest in her, because she's sort of a reminder of when he was in his life, happy and innocent and exploring the world in a way, I guess. When his life was filled with dread and sorrow, this was what he was like before all of that. A time when he didn't mess up every single relationship he ever had. A time when things were simple and he was happy, which is sort of the way Wanda is, that sort of innocence and happiness he had when he was in the 80s and the 90s. It's also great to see their contrasts when they do these interesting and subtle ways to just show their differences, show how they are just polar opposites to one another. Then we get episode 3, which is another great episode, as we see Bojack sort of trying to relive the good old days of the show with the people that are left and trying to get this book published that Herb himself requested, but it turned out the true reason why it wasn't published by people that Herb knew is because it would ruin his own legacy, because they didn't want him to be remembered for this, which brings so many ideas and themes in about legacy and what's really right. And even if a creator wants something to get released, is it okay to do so at the fault of it tarnishing their reputation? Which is why they made the hard choice to not let people see the book, which may not be the easy choice, but the choice that was probably necessary to them in their eyes. I love how it's not perceived as right or wrong. I think it works well in not exactly teaching us a lesson, but showing us a different point of view that makes sense. I feel like because of this, it just made it a more understandable way of themes of death and how it can be pointless and meaningless. And even if you try to find a meaning and point to it all, you're just going to end up with nothing. Episode 4 was very interesting in my opinion, because it gave context to the relationships in the show and the problems that will eventually be later addressed as the story goes along in an interesting way, and the way they're able to just show them and have us feel these sort of emotions. It was interesting. The chickens episode was alright. It was a fun little world building episode that had not much to do with the overall story, but in my opinion was a nice tidbit that sort of helped to move the overall plot in a fun way, I guess you could say. I also like the whole idea of Bojack trying to get his director to like him. It really sort of shows the kind of person he is. He's an insecure guy that just really wants people to like him and see him as a good person. And when somebody pushes him away and really doesn't care about him, he really desperately wants that approval from that person, which you could take back to when he was a kid or just how he is when he pushes people away that love him and tries to get affection from people that don't love him. I really like the Higher Love episode because it shows this insanely petty side to Bojack. After he says to his girlfriend that he loves him and she starts to be more distant to him, of course he's going to try to do something like hanging himself as a way to get her attention back, which is something I kind of wish
he of course just had to mess it up. He just had to push and to push to the point where it messes up everything
and made him seem to go wrong. Of course he finds as many ways as he possibly can for things to go back to the way they were when they were right. Hank After Dark is a great way of showing sexual misconduct, especially in an animated sitcom. They do it in a way that really matches the tone of the show, but also taking it seriously at the same time. They show these shady celebrities who get away with things like this solely because of the personalities and what people view them as. They don't seem as this type of person, and because he's a famous and well-known figure, he can get away with it easier than others can. This is something that happens in Hollywood and with other people that get allegations thrown at them, and even with there being a lot of evidence of it being true, they can get away with it because they're a likable figure. I've never seen anything like this explored before, and the fact that this is showing it in a show about a talking horse and did it so well speaks wonders. Let's Find Out is an episode that might be one of the best in the series, not because it's one of the funniest or the darkest, but because it shows the relationship between Mr. Peanut Butter and Bojack so perfectly, which this all happens solely because of Bojack's ego and him being insanely insecure and not wanting to be laughed at, and decides to insult his marriage on live television on a game show where Mr. Peanut Butter is sort of doing what he would do on a game show to Bojack and sort of making him look bad. This leads to some of the most real moments in the show where we see Mr. Peanut Butter get angry at Bojack as he talks about how angry he is about him kissing his wife and how he's wanted to be friends with him. This is a whole different side to him that we've never really seen before. We've always seen him as the guy who seems like he just can't take a clue, but this shows he's not an idiot. He just tries so hard to get him to like him and doesn't understand why he won't be his own friend. Then, of course, we get this scene from Bojack.
I want to feel good about myself the way you do, and I don't know how. I don't know if I can.
This shows their relationship in the most real way possible. That even though in so many ways they're the same, and Bojack is living the most successful life he ever has, he doesn't feel good about himself. Which is something Mr. Peanut Butter completely has. He feels good about who he is. He is happy, and while he can't take a clue in his marriage from time to time, he always will be the happy and joyful person we know him as. Which is why he doesn't want to be friends with him, and why he doesn't like him, because of Bojack's jealousy, because he would probably in so many ways want what he has but can't because of who he is. The Shot is a good episode that really shows the passion and care that Bojack has for the movie Secretariat, but also shows the sad reality of Hollywood, as because of this, it got Kelsey fired. It became this whole idea that Bojack ruined another life because of who he is. Also, the stuff with Princess Carolyn is great, as we see her living the life she's always wanted. However, she can't live that life yet because it's not what she wants yet. She wants to continue to work hard and finally earn that life in a satisfying way instead of taking a shortcut to it. She doesn't want to have this life in this way. She wants to keep pushing forward to get that life and earn it in a way that makes her satisfied. Yes And is the episode where we see Bojack and Wanda's relationship tragically fall apart. Is it in the most deep and profound way that we've seen in this show? No, but it's handled in a decent enough way that works quite well. Also, this pushed Bojack into this whole downward spiral, which only gets worse once Diane runs to his house. We see that Diane and Bojack are really not good together, because even if Diane can help Bojack at times, she clearly still has her own problems she has to fix. Because of that, she is a kind of a terrible influence with him, as we see throughout certain episodes that they really indulge each other in being lazy and not being able to do what they're supposed to do. We then see Bojack decide to escape from what he really enjoyed and goes to visit Penny, and we see him happy for one of the first times in the season. It's this idea of it seeming too good to be true. It almost seems impossible for it to be reality, that we see Bojack this happy, especially so early in the show. And the truth is, it's too early. And if you've seen up to this point in the show, you're just waiting until things come crashing down like they always eventually do. We then see Penny's daughter spending a whole lot of time with Bojack, and we want to think that Bojack is above this, that he wouldn't sleep with his old friend's daughter, that Bojack would never stoop this low, and he doesn't. He tells her she's too young to know what she wants and pushes her away, which seems too good to be true. Until he's talking to Penny, they seem to be having a very good time together. Probably the happiest Bojack's been in a while, until Bojack has to mess it up.
Oh, Bojack, I think you got the wrong idea.
He, of course, just had to mess it up. He just had to push and to push to the point where it messes up everything that made him happy. And of course, it takes a step even farther.
No.
Mom!
Charlotte.
Penny, go to your room.
We didn't even do anything!
Now, Penny.
Charlotte, I am so sorry.
Don't you dare. If you are not out of my driveway in 30 minutes, I will call the police. And if you ever try to contact me or my family again, I will fucking kill you.
Bojack really did something that we didn't expect from him. We thought he was better than this. We thought he would never do something like this, that Bojack would never go to this level. But he did, which I guess in a way makes us the people who thought too highly of him. Then, of course, we get a nice montage that is very fitting. It shows us that no matter where Bojack goes, no matter where he runs away to, LA or no LA, it's not the problem. He's the problem. He's what needs to be fixed. He's the problem. So because of that, he returns to where he inevitably belongs. Because at the end of the day, LA is his home, and he can't run from it. But he has to fix himself.
Out to Sea is probably the way to perfectly end the season off, with Bojack self-realizing how much he truly needs Todd. So I know we haven't talked too much about Todd, because it's hard to really talk about all of his storylines, since they are all just fun and entertaining to watch. However, we see that Todd, for once, wants Bojack to support him because it really means a lot to him. This is something that's really important to him, and wants Bojack to be there. But he doesn't show, and if Bojack didn't come to save Todd, he probably wouldn't have forgiven him. So it really is amazing when Bojack makes the right decision to help him. Bojack realizes that his friendship with him is one of the few he hasn't ruined yet, and wants to make it right, wants to not bear down and ruin this amazing friendship he has with him. Because the reality is, Todd is like one of the few people in his life that isn't cynical, that he's not jealous of at the same time. He's someone that he likes being around and is afraid of being alone, and because of that, he doesn't want Todd to leave. So we see him try to patch that relationship up, and it's probably the perfect way to end off the season.